this video series that I have just spontaneously decided to do, guided by spirit. Basically, I was told, why don't you just talk to your favorite people and share that with the world? And so this is what this is. And it came to me, you know, the 12 days of Christmas. And I thought, oh, why don't I do 12 days of conversation? And I think that in light of our current economic climate and the way that we're all isolated still to this day, connecting is even more important. And I know that for me personally, over the last 20 months now, I don't know what I would have done without this technology. And even the 5 months of the beginning of the pandemic, I was alone because both of my children were not with me, and I'm used to having them with me all the time. And so I was able to maintain a very strong connection, especially with my younger daughter, who was in Slovenia for the first 5 months of the pandemic. So I find this technology wonderful. And I do find it very personable. I know there are some people who don't, but for me, it's been a godsend. And I feel like I'm really connecting with people when I'm using this technology. But I'm also someone who's very comfortable being on camera, having been a speaker most of my career. So welcome to this format. I wish we were able to do it in person, but obviously at this point we're not. So thank you all for being here today. It's so exciting. I'm keeping it short, 30 minutes, because I know everybody has, you know, busy lives and things going on. But I've done 30-minute interviews in the past over this lunch hour and found it to be very successful being interviewed at that time of day. And then, of course, I'm going to have the replay up on YouTube for you. So why would we focus on this topic? For most of you who are in the audience right now, and probably for those listening in the replay, you're aware that we are in a major spiritual transition right now on our planet. We have been in the energy of fear and the energy of competition, which is a very masculine, patriarchal energy, for a very, very long time. And that is shifting. It is dramatically shifting right now. We're moving into an evolution of our species and an evolution of our actual planet herself. And so I was just watching a video just recently where I was watching the energies, the actual plasma energies on our planet, protecting us from some of the darker energies that are out there. So this is very, very exciting. And so why would we talk about this spiritual evolution? Because the reason why is because we want to be moving forward with it. We don't want to be sticking our head in the sand and not actively participating, because your soul wants you to actively participate in this experience. You're here for the journey. You're not here for the end result. So let me say that again. You're not here for when 5D hits. You're here for your soul to experience the journey of going through 3D, 4D, and 5D. It is super, super exciting. And so what I want to start with today, and this is what I'm going to start with every guest, is, you know, what's the energy that you bring to the table in your life? Are you someone that allows the external to influence you and bring you down and have you stay in that energy of fear? Or are you able to lift yourself out of that? So there's three words that I use in my life a lot. And one of them is passion, one is purpose, and one is play. And I really feel that when we can live our lives from a passionate, purposeful, playful place, then we're able to really attract in a very different kind of lifestyle, a different kind of energy, a different kind of way of being, and even different experiences and different people that will come in when you're playing from that kind of energetic arena. So I thought about it today. I thought, well, what are some of the things that people do in order to keep that energy up? And so of the people that I speak to, of course, meditation is a big one. And that's, you know, it's a buzzword. It's been a buzzword for a long time now, probably a decade. And, you know, these meditation events that I've been running every Wednesday night have been so successful. People are sharing with me that they're listening to them. They're getting energetic experiences out of them. They're finding that the messages relate to the lives that they're living. So using crystals and using nature and taking the time to just settle into the space. So I myself use a lot of oracle cards, and I use meditation, and I go out into nature, and I find that that helps me to stay grounded. But now let's think about it for a second of how do we access what our purpose is here on life, in life, on the earth, right? And so the energy of that from before has all been about, it's been all about doing and creating, you know, success. And that energy is completely changing now. It's not about money anymore. And of course, we're not there yet, but it's the idea that, imagine this. So imagine 100 years ago, when the agricultural revolution was completely in force. We had farms, we were living off of the land. We didn't have all the things that we have now. We were somewhat, let's say, ignorant of what was possible, because we were just living in that energetic environment. And so then as we went through the 1900s, we came into the Industrial Revolution. So just going to share with you a little bit of the history. We've had the Industrial Revolution, which brought us away from farms and into the cities and working in manufacturing and creating those kinds of environments where we're no longer really in survival from the land perspective. We're now in survival from an industrial perspective. Now we have bosses. Now we have wage limits. Now we're no longer bartering. We're now earning a living, and we're leaving our families to do that. And then we go through, you know, two major wars and depressions. And then we move into the kind of, let's call it the food revolution. So in the 60s, the industry of food completely changes, and we start not eating from the land. We're now eating from the factories. We're eating all of this processed food, and even looking at our healthcare system, in the 20s, I understand, the Rothschilds discovered that the pharmaceutical industry could be created from petroleum. And alternative healing was no longer, it was no longer the way of healing. It was the way of healing when we were on the farms and we were working with the land and we were using all those healthy plants. So they come in and they change everything. And now what is, you know, plant medicine becomes the alternative way to heal. So now we're no longer even connected to ourselves and our bodies, because we're no longer using those methods to heal ourselves. We're now using all these pharmaceutical drugs made from petroleum, made from oil and gas, to profit someone else. So there's no more passion, purpose, and play. It's about profit. It's not about people anymore. And then we go through the technological revolution in the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, and then we hit the digital revolution in the 90s and the early 2000s. And all of a sudden now we're digital. So now you might think that that's a bad thing, but actually it's not. See, what had to happen was we had to step away from where we were. There's a channeler that I watched once who described this, that the divine feminine stepped away in order to allow the masculine energy to come through on the planet to be able to create all of these revolutions for our benefit. And now we sit as in 2020 and 2021, And now we're bringing back the divine feminine, and we're bringing back the energy of love, and we're bringing back connection to nature, and we're bringing back our connection to our purpose and to our soul. And we're bringing it back with the help of all of this revolution that's happened, all of this evolution that's happened. So we had to kind of go through that whole growth experience to be able to get to where we are now. And this is an absolutely magical time. So over the next 3 weeks, I'm going to be interviewing different individuals who've made a difference in my life. And these individuals are fun, and they're interesting, and they're motivating, and they're inspiring. They're all entrepreneurs, and they're all out there in the world now, beginning to share from an energetic perspective. And they all have philosophy backgrounds where they've read about life, they've worked on themselves, they've done their own personal development, and they're in the world inspiring other people, including me and you. And I'm just so excited about bringing them forward. So each one will be at 12 o'clock, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Fridays for the next 2 weeks. And then the last week, the run up to Christmas, I'm going to do Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, because Friday is Christmas Eve. And so it's really exciting. Because each person is going to bring something very unique. They're going to bring their story, stories about how they've learned how to live in their purpose and how they're living in that energy of passion, purpose, and play. And they're also going to share a little bit about their spiritual journey and how they've gotten to where they are. And then they're going to talk a little bit about this sacred economics piece, which I'll get to in a minute. But most of you in this call know me, but for anyone who's listening or who doesn't know me, let me share with you a little bit of my journey. So I was just a regular, normal person living a 3D life, a stay-at-home mom in the 1990s and into the early part of the 2000s. And I had been with my partner, my husband, for over 20 years at that point. And things were not going well in our marriage. And in fact, things were not going well with me. So everything looked very rosy on the outside, but on the inside, things were really crumbling. And so as most of us know, you know, we can really come to a standstill when our body begins to fall apart. And that's what happened to me. I went into early menopause and I had adrenal burnout and thyroid dysfunction. And when I went to my doctor, the allopathic doctor system, I was told I would have to go on medication for the rest of my life. And I said, I'm not doing that. I don't know what drove me to say that, but I just knew that that wasn't for me. So I started on this journey of healing by diving into books from the library on how to heal the menopause naturally. And then discovering that my whole endocrine system was completely entrenched with trauma, stress, and hormones. And I began to understand that there was some other kind of connection in my body that was creating these problems that I was having, not to mention the dysfunction that I was dealing with in my marriage. So it took me down this rabbit hole of recovery where I needed to discover who I really was, because I had become this kind of automaton Stepford wife in my marriage and my family. My marriage didn't survive. That's actually a blessing. But I then went on to train to be a coach because I realized that I had a story to share. I had help that I could give to people, and I could inspire people with my stories of courage and change. And I didn't think about it like that at the time. It was only when people talked to me afterwards, said, wow, you're so courageous and that's so inspiring. I didn't really see it that way. Because I'm sure, as many of you know, when you're in a survival situation and you do what you have to do, you don't think about, well, I'm being brave doing this. You just do it, right? So I did that. And as part of my coaching work, I discovered that there was a huge spiritual component to the work that I brought to the table. And I really didn't understand it. And so around 2014, I took the year off, and because my business wasn't working. I had been working with women. I had been running groups and programs and doing workshops and working with individuals. But for some reason, I kind of ground to a halt. And in that year, I hired a coach. It cost me over five figures. And I really thought that he was going to get my business up and running. But what he really did was he stopped me. He stopped me and said, Gail, your calendar's crazy. You're out every night. You're talking to people, but you're not getting anywhere. You're spinning your wheels. Just get everything off your calendar. For an extrovert like me, that was just insane. But it was really what I needed. And so what's one of the things I would bring to you today is one of the benefits that I have now is I'm able to discern between my flow and my forcing. And so I can really know now, oh, I need to take downtime. I need to take time to myself. I need to stop this, you know, incessant running around. And I really think that COVID has been a gift for many of us in that respect, where we've been forced to stop the hamster wheel life that we were living and to go back inside and to get out into insight into ourselves and to get back out into nature and to really assess what really is important in life. So those 12 months that I worked with that coach, that was kind of, I was doing it 7 years ahead of time and really beginning to understand who mattered in my life and what mattered in my life and why. And I met several other spiritual teachers who kind of created shifts in me where I was able to begin to access unique spiritual gifts that I didn't really know I'd ever had. But as I say that to you now, I guarantee that for those of you who also have this, you've known it in some way or another throughout your life. You've known certain things, you've seen certain things, you've become aware of certain things, and you've maybe worked on them and tapped into them and followed them, but maybe like me, you didn't. You just ignored them. And part of being a spiritual warrior and a spiritual entrepreneur is being able to recognize when those hits are coming to you and to kind of take yourself off the beaten path, the way that society says that we should do business and the way society says we should be this or that, and really focus in on what actually works for us. So over these last 7 years, I've had to really sit down, and I've tried to do it the way other people do it out there, and it doesn't work for me. Maybe it's worked for you or it works for people you know, but it doesn't work for me. So what I've discovered is that when I can really connect to source, to my higher self, to my soul, things flow. They flow much better than when I'm trying to force things and make things work and actually work with the economy that we've been trying to operate under for the last 100 years. So my invitation to you is to, you know, take some time every day if you can to just kind of stop and connect with yourself and say, what do I need today? And every morning I ask, what do you want me to do today? And I stop and I listen. And sometimes it's the craziest things. Let's go for a walk in the trees. Go call this person. Go write a blog, whatever. And every time that I do that, I've discovered that that's when I can be most use of most service to people, because I'm following my path. I'm following my soul. And so I want you to really imagine that your soul is this beautiful, bright, shining light that's with you always. They're always with you. They're always just to the side, just above, just in front of you, just behind you. And if you can just tap into an energy that is you, and your soul is you in all the lives that you're living right now, and it's got great wisdom that it can share with you. And that's how I try to do it on a day-to-day basis. I try to just tap in, ask, and listen. And then, of course, the key is following the action, right? Taking action around what your soul is telling you to do. And if you find that that's tough and you're not really hearing, then just sit quietly and just listen to that small voice in your head. And it's not going to be a loud voice. It's not going to be, yeah, go and do this. It's not going to be like that. It's just going to be a hint of an idea. And if you dismiss it, it'll probably come back around another time and you'll think to yourself, oh, I remember hearing that. And so really looking at how we are operating in this world now. So like my business now is built only on that kind of direction. And I've spent the last year surrendering. And I think for many of us, like the last 2 years now, if you think back to who you were, December 7th, or is today the 6th, December 6th, 2019. Then, you know, what was your life like December 6th, 2019? Were you living where you're living? Were you working in the same job you're working in? Were you socializing with the same people you're socializing with now? Everything has kind of changed for those of us who are kind of on this path. And now I'm understanding that more and more people are wakening up to who they really are. And they don't need to have a, you know, a breakdown experience like I had or like some of you may have had. They're just becoming aware that there's more to them than just this physical body that they're in the world in. There are bigger things at play. And there are huge things at play right now on our planet and in our world. And so how can you on a daily basis stay in this energy of passion and purpose and play? And you'll know what your purpose is because it will feel like the most natural thing in the world for you to do. It will feel as easy as breathing. There'll be lots of flow with it. The right people will show up at the right time. And you'll be guided and it will flow smoothly. Now, does it mean it won't be challenging? No, because I'm one to tell you that surrendering to spirit is a challenging experience for us as human beings. We have an ego that has been programmed so deeply with the narrative that's out there of creating success by profit, you know, and really not thinking about coming from that intuitive source that you have. And each of the people that I'm interviewing this next 3 weeks are all people who have had, you know, these kinds of experiences that I'm talking about, where they've been in the world just a normal person, and they've really had to discover, you know, who are they? What makes them tick? What kinds of experiences have brought them to their knees? And then lifted them up out of that. And we all have mentors. We all have people in our lives that have done that for us. And so, you know, as you're moving through this series, you know, think about the people who have done that for you. And if there's some way that you can express gratitude to them, especially at this time of year, where you can express gratitude without it costing you a penny. You know, you can do a call like this with someone. You can just call them up on the phone. You can send them a text. You can send them a card. Just tell them you love them. Just tell them how much you appreciate them, what they bring to you. I called someone yesterday morning who I've known for over 12 years and thanked her for the support that she's given to me. She's always been supportive in my life since we met at one little meetup on Young and Eglinton, and we've worked together. She's come to my events. She's referred me business, and she's always been there for me. And when she said, when she got my phone call yesterday morning, she said, Gail, you can't begin to believe how much I needed to hear this today. That's part of our spiritual journey, is sharing love with other people. And this is part of the reason why I'm doing this series, is because Spirit said to me, spread the love, share the love, show people that there are people out there who are really assisting other people with the work that they do that's of a different kind. It's not your average, you know, regular business that's out there that's all about profit. And they all have their own quirks and beautiful things that they bring. So I'm so excited for you to see these experiences and to meet these people that I have known now for quite a long time. Now, the last piece of this that I'll just share very quickly is, what is the sacred economics thing that I've mentioned about before and in my emails? Sacred economics is the practice of doing business where everything is a win-win situation, and it's not always about transacting money. So if any of you listening to this or watching have bartered with anyone for business, you'll know what I'm talking about. But the other idea with sacred economics is that it's not always you as the giver who receives, and it's not always the person receiving who gives. So you may find that you're able to create a business transaction where you're actually also giving to someone else, someone who's not actually in the transaction between you and the business owner. Or maybe you're bringing them a payment, but it's a completely different kind of payment. And the one that really floors me is where you receive a service and the person who's charging you doesn't tell you how much it costs, but they ask you to value it and pay what you think it's worth after you've received it. So these are all ideas that are coming out of a sacred economics course that I've been on for the past year. And it really is about, if you've ever heard of B Corp, it's about people, planet, and profit. So it's not that it's not about money. Money is one of our barters, but it's definitely about people. And it's absolutely about the energy of the planet. So each person that comes is going to make an offer under the criteria of sacred economics that I've shared a little bit with you today. And the really cool thing is that for every person that comes onto my show and is interviewed, I will match whatever sacred economics offering they bring. So if somebody brings something for free, I'm going to give something for free. If they offer something where you pay afterwards with the value, I will do that too. So each day you will get the opportunity to connect with me if you're interested in what that person is offering. Some things might not be for you, but if it is, all you have to do is text me that you love sacred economics and you want to play with this particular person, and you'll be the winner. So you'll have until 12 noon of the next day when the next interview starts to actually claim that. Some people might not claim anything, and I might have multiple people who want something. I've no idea. That's why this is a play. It's an experiment. It's just getting out there and really changing things up, because that's what our world is going through right now, is just major change. So as I said, you will have that time to connect with me, and then these videos will be up on YouTube after they've uploaded through Zoom. And I'm excited. I'm going to make this a series so that, you know, you can see all these different people. So it's wonderful to have you here. For those of you who are listening, thank you for listening to the replay. And until tomorrow at 12 noon, where my guest will be the beautiful and wonderfully talented Jean Price. She is a diva extraordinaire, and she brings absolutely fantastic stories and wisdom to the table. So I'm so excited for having her as my first guest. And for now, thank you so much for coming and listening and being with me here at the first season, the first episode of this season. Mwah! Big kisses and hugs to you. Thank you for being here, and I will see you tomorrow, same time, same place.
Thank you. Thanks.
Bye.